Berkay.
Hadi.
Şimdi evimizden çıktık ve yaklaşık 10 saniye oldu Berkay aşkım.
Bence.
Ve stüdyoya geldik bile. Ya ev stüdyonun hemen yanında ve kalabalık başlamış şimdi. Not stoked at all. Talk to camera, boss.
Coconut water.
How are you?
So welcome. As we get started, why don't we just come? I think the floors are warm, right?
Yeah.
Come close and let's chat a little bit so I don't have to yell. And in the back room, can you guys hear my voice? I'm joking, right? So we're gonna tonight's called the Master Practice, and the idea is to elevate the conversation as a whole. What does it mean to master something? And this is something we talked about last year, but every year developing a little bit more. What does it mean to master something? And just throw out whatever comes to mind. Go into details. What do you mean?
Best friend here.
Okay. Any other ideas? Mastery. What does it mean?
Once you realize something on your own, it's not about just you learn and practice, then you think you know, but then you come to some realization.
I love that. So those two things are kind of starting to formulate the steps, the path, the journey. Has anybody ever played an instrument, learned to play an instrument? There's like a lot of, and it's like, yes. Did anybody ever learn to play the trumpet? No? Yes! Come close. Me too, that was my first instrument. So, what's the first thing they teach you when you're learning an instrument?
Repeat.
Before that.
Put it back together.
That's the first stage. It's actually breaking apart the pieces, learning how it functions, how things work, learning the relationships between things. And then the next stage is actually then the practice. It's actually starting to use everything that you, all of the pieces, start to bring them together and start to express yourself through the instrument. And then the final stage is actually, which you shared, we're also emotional beings. And we start to break apart the pieces, we start to experience challenges, other things start to arise. And one of the things that I struggled with for a long time is that as a yogi and a yoga teacher, I was always looking to be perfect, right? So things would come up in relationships or in challenges in life, and I said like, oh, I need to work on that. And what I thought is when I'm working on it, I need to kind of get it to the point where it doesn't exist anymore. So like for me, jealousy was my thing for many, many years. And I just was thinking like, oh, I'm a yoga teacher, like how can I be jealous? Okay, I'm in a new relationship, I'm not gonna be jealous. And then pretty soon, holy fuck, here it comes. work, challenge, meditate. But it doesn't go away, right? So then I started to learn, okay, what's the next step? How do I actually embrace it and start to use it? And what I realized is that for me, using it and practicing it meant taking that energy and doing something with it. And what I found out is that when I was jealous, it was just me wanting attention and affection, right? And I started to say, okay, well, what do I need? I need to ask for it. And that was the transformation. That took something that I thought was negative, but I used it as a positive energy. And this is something that we all need to learn how to do on this journey. And then ultimately, we want to get to the space where we're not dependent so much on the instrument anymore, that the spirit is actually moving through us in a way where the player and the instrument are one. And I often think about, like, okay, like the people that have mastered things in their life, I think John Lennon, right? John Lennon was an amazing musician, but at a certain point, he was not just about music. He was a being, an entity. And he said, he represents this. This is a person who took, and there's many people like this, Picasso, all these artists, anybody who spent a lot of time and energy and really kind of, let's say, suffered for their art, they actually got to know themselves to the place where they as beings, there was no separation, and they came through more clearly. But this is the path that we're on, and all of us are at different stages of this path. So as you practice tonight, my job is to challenge you a little bit. I'm gonna put you into the fire, and we wanna see what comes up. And whatever comes up, we wanna learn how to work with it, because all of those pieces are part of you. And we need to learn how to embrace them. We need to actually learn how to work with them. You guys ready to rock out?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, stay as you are. Hello, welcome. You just missed an amazing talk.
I was with the other class, and then I was just circling here. I got loads of racing numbers.
Okay, welcome. I'll repeat it tomorrow, don't worry. Absolutely. We actually know very, very deeply. We're very easily disconnected from this knowing. But as soon as we're aware, we come back. We're going to chant Om three times. As we chant Om, listen to one another. There are so many people in this room who are on the very same journey that we are on. And it feels good to know that on this journey, we are never alone. Take a deep inhale. Come to your mats and stand into dasana tonight, feet together.